decide at your own free will. You are the author of your ideas. You are the creator of your thoughts. You bear responsibility of what you think, decide, and do. But let's look carefully into what makes you think or decide on something. Take anything you have ever thought and see why you thought it. You thought it because there is an intention in you to think so. The thought comes due to your intention of thinking that way. Thoughts are your thoughts because the intentions behind those thoughts are your intentions. Thoughts are yours because you are the one that intend to think so. From where does these intentions come? Do the intentions come from your free will? Desires are the ones that built up into intentions. The origin of all your intentions is desire. From why you need to pay attention to hear a bang of crackers, from why you want to gaze at night sky, from why you want to understand what is life, and from why you need to live and don't want to die. The root reason is desire. Intentions are your intentions because they are outcomes of your desires. Intentions are yours because they are there to satisfy your desires. What are desires? Where are they come from? Are they really yours? And are they operate at your free will? The axiom of desire. Desire is a compulsive command that you take for granted to be your intrinsic free need. Desire is a written script. It is already there, and there is no authorship of you to them. There is no free will of you in desire. Desire is an axiom, an unquestioned starting point of your reasoning. You believe that you achieve something called pleasure by satisfying desires. You believe it is good to have pleasure, and it is bad to have pain. You believe that you must acquire as much pleasure as you can, and you shouldn't get pain. Let's do a thought experiment and understand it clearly. Close your eyes and be aware of a pain you feel in your body. Concentrate on one pain. Carefully examine that pain. Examine what that pain is consisting of. What you are receiving as pain is a certain sensation. See what makes that sensation into a pain. See, it contains only a sensation. Pain is a label you imposed onto that sensation. Pain is pain because you take for granted that sensation as pain. Take the sensation as sensation only. See, there is no pain in it. See the conceptual nature of pain. There is pain in a sensation because you accept that sensation to be pain. There is no inherent pain in any sensation. Give up this illusion of accepting sensations as pains. See just with that, all pains become mere sensations. See, it is same with all pleasure. All these pains are sensations. There are no pains as such. All these pleasures are sensations. There are no pleasures as such. There is nothing you receive by the name of being happy. There is nothing you lose by the name of being in pain. The belief that you get pleasure, which you definitely shall by satisfying desires, originates the feeling that you are the one that do desire, and therefore desires are your desires. This belief is only an emotion. It is only an illusion that exists at your ignorance of what desires are. Desires are not part of you, and so are intentions. Your belief that desire means your free will makes you believe that these thoughts are your doing. The notion of free will. The notion that what you think are what you want to think. The notion that you think them at your free will. The notion that you are the author of them. This notion is only an emotion. There is nothing you want. Nothing is thought because you want to think. Nothing is decided because you want to decide. Nothing is done because you want to do. Conceive, these thoughts are not your doing. They are not any part of you. Thoughts are not you. It is a colossal mistaken identity you are living in. Give up the notion that you are the doer. You are the one who walk. You are the one who think. You are the one that think this very thought. You are only the passive observer of them. to see it within yourself and become mindful of your mind. Let's find a calm place and practice mindfulness. Take desires one by one and start seeing the true nature of them and let them go off. Do not attempt to imagine to be battling with them or throwing them off with effort. Just know the true nature of them and release them. See the fear. See the anger. See the joy. Understand they are not part of you and let them go. See the desire for survival and let it go. Consider a pain in your body. There is a certain sensation. See, it contains only a sensation. Pain is a label you impose onto it. And let it go. Look at the thought in your mind this very moment. Carefully conceive, this very thought is not your doing. And let it go. Let the mind be silent from brain chatter. Let there be only thoughtless awareness. Practice to be mindful of what you realized. Physical body is not part of you. There is no soul. Desires and intentions are not part of you. Mind is not part of you. You are only the passive subject. When you get the ability to genuinely and clearly see this, it makes a state of tranquility. Release of a tension you have been with so long yet not knowing about it. A relief you have never experienced before. Practice to get at this peace of mind and be with it for a long time.